at the Myrtles.
Look, what are you talking? What are you talking? What are you talking?
You can talk, you can talk. You can bicker, you can talk. You can bicker, bicker, bicker. You can talk, you can talk. You can talk, 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 talk. Bicker, bicker, bicker. You can talk all you want about as him as it was.
No, it ain't. No, it ain't. But you gotta know the territory.
Shh, 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 shh. Ever meet a fellow by the name of Hill?
Hill.
Hill? Hill?
Hill?
Hill.
No. Just a minute.
Never heard of any salesman, Bill.
Now he doesn't know the territory.
Doesn't know the territory.
What's about his lawn? Just a minute.
He doesn't worry about his lawn.
Never worries about his lawn.
Or a doggone thing. He's just a banging, bell ringing, big haul, breako, necker nothing, rip roaring, advertising bullseye salesman. That's Professor Harold Hill. Harold Hill.
Tell us, what's his line? What's his line?
He's a bank and he doesn't know the territory.
Look, what do you talk? What do you talk?
He's a music man.
He's a what?
He's a music man, and he sells clarinets to the kids in the town with the big trombones and the rat-a-tat drums and the big brass bass, and the piccolo, uniforms too, with the shiny gold braid on the coat and the big red stripe running.
Well, I don't know much about fans, but I do know you can't make a living selling big trombones, no sir. Mandolin picks, perhaps, in here and there, a juicer?
No, the fella sells bands, boys bands. I don't know how he does it. But he lives like a king, and he dallies and he gabbles, and he plucks and he shines. And when the man dances, certainly, boys, what else? The piper pays him. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. When the man dances, certainly, boys, what else? The piper pays him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But he doesn't know the territory!
Thank you.
step will be to get your town out of the serious trouble it's in.
River City's not in any trouble.
Then I'll have to create some. I need to find a desperate need for a boys band. You remember. Now, what's new around here? What can I use?
Nothing. Except the billiard parlor just put in a new pool table.
They never had a pool table before.
No, only billiards.
That'll do. Either you're closing your eyes to a situation you don't wish to acknowledge, or you're unaware of the caliber of disaster indicated by the presence of a pool table in your community. Well, you got trouble, my friend. Right here, I say, trouble right here in River City. Why, sure, I'm a billiard player, certainly mine, and proud to say I'm always mighty proud to say. I consider that the hours I spend with a cue in my hand are golden. Help me cultivate a horse sense and a cool head and a keen eye. Now, friends, let me tell you what I mean. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pockets in a table. Pockets that mark the difference between a gentleman and a bum with a capital B that rhymes with P and that stands for pool. Now, I know all you folks are the right kind of parents. I'm gonna be perfectly frank. Like to know what kind of conversation goes on while we're loafing around that hall. They'll be trying out Beagle, trying out Cubex, trying out TaylorMade's like cigarette beans, and bragging all about how they're gonna cover up a telltale breath with scents. And one fine night, they leave the pool hall, heading for the dance at the armory, libertine men and scarlet women, and ragtime, shameless music that'll drag your son and your daughter through the armory of trouble and mascaria. Friends, the idle brain is the devil's playground. Trouble!
Oh, we are trouble!
Right here in River City!
Right here in River City!
We got a T that rhymes with P and that stands for pool.
That stands for pool!
We surely got trouble!
We surely got trouble!
Right here in River City!
Right here!
Gotta figure out a way to keep the young ones moral after school.
Our children gotta have trouble!
Mothers of River City, heed the warning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The moment your son leaves the house, does he rebuckle his knickerbockers below the knee?
No!
Are certain words creeping into his conversations? Words like swell,
no!
And cultural man,
no!
If so, my friends, you got trouble.
Oh, we got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here in River City.
With a capital T that rhymes with P and that stands for fool.
That stands for fool.
We surely got trouble.
We surely got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here.
With a T.
Anyone else in this town? There you go again with that same old comment. ovation for leading the singing. As mayor of River City, I welcome you River Citizens to the 4th of July exercises set up for the indoors here in Madison Gymnasium accounts the weather. Four score. The members of the school board will now present a patriotic tableau. Yes, the members of the school board will not present a patriotic tableau. Some disagreement about costumes, I suppose. Instead, the Watani girls of the local wigwam of Hiawatha will present a spectacle, my life, in which my wife will take a leading part.
Right behind. There were more you counterdict me?
We is just blocking cheese old Pete's.
You watch your phraseology. I know what you was doing. My little Gracie senior. Now you stay away from my oldest girl, or you'll hear from me till who laid the rails. Bill, I'll talk to you Monday morning about this band thing over at City Hall. 10 o'clock sharp. Man, I want his credentials.
Constable, I'll be responsible for the boy. You don't know this kid. He's tough, and he's got his gate waiting outside. Now, Constable, let me show you how to break up a gang. Oh, young lady. Oh, miss. What's your name?
Zanita. I don't have any idea who's begging me. He got.
Zanita, do you know Tommy Jules?
Well, I...
Tommy, this is Zanita. Escort the young lady home. By way of the candy kitchen.
Yes, sir.
You have to.
Yes, sir. You got.
Professor, you're a pretty bright young fella. You made a couple mistakes, though.
Oh?
The mayor happens to own the billiard parlor and a new pool table.
Okay, what was my other mistake?
That's Nita. She's the mayor's oldest girl.
Just a minute, Professor Hale. We need your credentials. We're the school board.
Academic certificate.
Nothing on the soul.
We need letters and papers. Make you put up a bond.
What am I hearing? Say,
ice cream. Ice cream, but I don't see him, man. That's
all right. Talk then.
Down here. Ice cream.
Talk slow.
Ice cream.
Singing is only sustained talking.
Now you ice cream.
Now you ice cream.
Now you
say
ice cream.
Ladies, from now on, you'll never see one of these men without the other three.
Oh, Professor, you're wrong. Why, they've hated each other for 15 years.
Ice cream, how can there be innocent and sincere? Aren't we sincerely in love?
We're in love.
Expression of mind and movement.
Mr. Hill!
You must
You must accept.
Lady McKechnie Shin, dancing. Will I?
Then you accept.
Yes, indeed, and I would like to.
Thank you. And now, Marion Prue, I believe. After all, she is the librarian.
Playing
Didn't I say get that spellbinder Harold Hill's credentials? I said it more than a July 4th, 19 and 12.
Yes, John.
And now the whole town's turned upside down. The school board singing up street and down alley.
I found something very interesting in this book about Professor Hill's alma mater.
His who?
His university.
I know all about that. In fact, that's the only thing I can ever get out of him.
Gary can serve his movie to laugh a lot.
If you'll just take time to read a little bit about the conservatory, you won't have to look further. It's on page...
Papa! The Wells Fargo wagon just came in from the depot!
The Wells Fargo wagon? At this time of day?
It can't be the band instrument!
The band instrument? I want that man's credentials! you, madam.
I think he means he.
You know what I see written all over you? Reform school. The get out, you wild kid, get out. Watch your phraseology. Now go home, young woman. Go home!
Dear Jim, I want you to know that I'm vouching for Tommy Dooley. That boy's got the confidence of every kid in town. You'll be waiting in line to shake his hand by the time our band plays its first concert.
By the time your band plays its first concert, the individual members will have to foregather in wheelchairs on account of the broken legs they'll get from tripping over their beards. Now let me tell you something, my fine young feather, or my feather young, oh never mind, Lord Jason, you are holding! I want his references and I want them tonight. Now don't let him out of your sight, he is slipperier than a Mississippi sturgeon.
Professor Hale, I think Mayor Shin has behaved abominably, and I think it was wonderful of you coming to Tommy's defense.
Well, a man can't avoid conflict every time a personal risk is involved. What does the poet say? A coward dies 1,000 deaths, and the brave man only 500.
I just wish I was a little more informed. I've been wanting to talk to you about Winthrop Cornett.
It's Cornett, mother of Pearl Kings.
I'm sure it's fine. He tells me about some think system. If he thinks the minuet in G, he won't have to bother with the notes. Now, Professor...
Mary. The think system is a revolutionary method, I'll admit. But I cannot discuss these things here in public. But if you'll allow me to call, when may I call?
Why, any night this week.
Golden shoe in your hair and a silver shoe for all to see. We know that you will soon unfold her giving heart and pure as gold.
I guess. Then you must know about that fella Hill over the band. Yes. Well, don't let it worry you no longer. I got the goods on him in spades. Swindling two-bit thimble rigger. I'm just passing through. Number 8 only makes a 15-minute water stop. Who are you? My name's Charlie Cow. But right now, I'm just out to protect the good name of the traveling fraternity from that swindler.
Mr. Cow, you're making a big mistake.
Mistake, my old lady's corset cover. That fella's been the raspberry seed my wisdom tooth just long enough. Say, what kind of music teacher are you? You didn't see Broom. He's no more professor.
I know all about that. Band leaders are always called professor. It's a harmless deception. He's a fine director and...
Wait a minute. Fine director. Have you heard one note of music from any band?
No, but I...
For nothing, girly girl! That fella's never made a band in his life, and he never will!
Well, you'll never make that train at the depot. You'll have to catch it at the crossing.
No, sir. I got the word. And I can see you're not the one to leave it.
I never met a man who sells anvils before. That's something, well, quite... different.
Takes a real salesman, I can tell you that. Animals have a limited appeal. What am I doing? I'm gonna stop trying, I'll get fired.
I don't agree.
Not out here, King Tide. How do I help you deliver these letters?
Try me.
got it. When's the freight go? 9:40 from the junction.
It's not even 8:30 yet.
Look, you want to turn a whirl around here and get yourself caught in the trap? You be my guest.
Don't worry, Marks. I'll meet you at the hotel in plenty of time. Miss Marion, you were late.
But you said 15 minutes.
Well, I meant to say that you were, well, about 26 years too late. It took you all this time to get to the footbridge with the fella.
If you want to know the truth, it was almost longer.
Oh?
Halfway here, I nearly turned back. I suppose I'm not the first to find it easier to think clearly when I'm under the spell of your salesmanship.
Now, Miss Marion, surely you don't believe I've been selling you anything.
No, you've given me something. That's why I decided to come.
Don't recall that it's
the truth, didn't you?
Now I'm bigger than you, and you're gonna stand here and give it all, so you might as well quit wiggling. Now, there's two things you're entitled to know. One, you're a wonderful kid. I thought so from the first. That's why I wanted you in the band. So you'd quit moping around and feeling sorry for yourself.
What band?
I always think there's a band, kid.
What's the other thing I'm entitled to know?
Well, now that I think of it, it's really none of your business.
I'm with you! Never come to River City!
No, you don't, Winthrop.
Fester, you believe him?
I believe everything he ever said, especially since the kids have looked around here all summer and walked and acted, especially you, and the parents, too. Does Mama wish he'd never come to River City?
Well, you do, don't you?
No, Winthrop. Now go, Harold, please.
Go on, Professor.
I can't go, Winthrop.
Why not?
Because for the first time in my life, I got my foot caught in the door.
Greg! Greg! Greg, they are here that way! That way!
Go on, Professor! That way! That way!
Virtue has triumphed! The sword of retribution has cut down Professor Harold Hill. And if there are those, as I have heard, who are melting tar and collecting feathers, I will not say them nay.
Well, I should think there ought to be some of you who could forget our everlasting, I was stubborn, chip-on-the-shoulder arrogance long enough to remember River City before Harold Hill arrived. Do you remember? Well, do you? Surely some of you ought to be grateful for what he's given this town. And if so, I should think you'd want to admit it.
You're wasting a great deal of time there. If there is anyone here who does not believe this man Hill should be tarred and feathered, please step forward. You lately step back! Have you people forgotten how you bought expensive uniforms, technical instruction books, and high-priced band instruments? Have you forgotten the clear understanding and warranty that your child would be taught to play in a band? Well, where's the band? Where's the band?
Think, men. Think.